common one with kids I come in. If I had a dime every time a kid told me this. Teachers being unfair. Oh my God, too much homework, not listening, always picking the other kid over me. All these different things. So they go through the whole thing. They're like, you know what, she should have been listening. She always takes the other side and kind of goes through all these things. And so I'm like, eventually I go through and I'm like, okay, why does she have to listen, or why does he have to listen? Well, they're the teacher. And I'm like, so teachers have to listen? Yeah. Well, obviously she doesn't, or he doesn't, because you're telling me they didn't, right? And they're like, well, no, they didn't. I'm like, so they don't have to. But they're supposed to. It's in the school, like thing. It's like, they tell us that they have to do this. And I'm like, so everything that happens in the school plan and the description of what happened, all those rules are always followed. Well, no. And I'm like, so why are you saying this to yourself? It would be nice if the teacher was going to listen to you. It would be nice if the teacher took your side. But they don't have to. And I try to start changing them, because by the time they're usually coming to see me, they did something. Teacher didn't listen. And then they like hit somebody. They cussed out the teacher. Made the random threat, which then kicks in that, oh, get them out of school, you know, because they're going to be the next whatever. So their actions has gotten out of control. So I'm starting to convince them, or trying to show them, of the fact that I don't have a problem with you being angry. I have a problem that you got so angry you're now in trouble and sitting in a therapist's office. And usually they're like, okay. And so the goal is not to get as angry. So this would be part of it. It's like, so change what you're saying to yourself. Instead of saying, well, you know what, the teacher, she better listen to me, or he better. Think, I hope they do, but they don't have to. Now, if they don't, you're still going to be angry, but you're probably not going to be as angry. If you're not as angry, the chances of you doing something to get kicked out of school, get your parents called, get sent to see me, is going to go down. And then they get more free time, which is usually the care that they like. So, all right. So, basically what I'm going through with all this is that irrational thoughts will increase our unpleasant emotions. Rational thoughts don't necessarily get rid of our unpleasant emotions, but they're not going to intensify them. Unfortunately, sometimes we're going to be sad. Sometimes we're going to be mad. That's just part of being humans. That's part of being alive. But we don't have to get it worse. Important point for the kids to get. And also that they know, you know what? You have some control over this. You can make it so you don't feel worse. So one of the things that I'm often told is that, well, people, they make me mad. You know what? If they didn't do such and such, I wouldn't have been mad. They made me mad. And which I usually let them go on for quite a while. So basically what I do is I try to point out that, you know, people can do things and they can get you mad. But you know what? They can't actually make you mad. Never have a kid who believe it. They're like, nope, you're wrong on this one, Tim. They're convinced that they got me. Actually, if I could get a volunteer, anyone, I will drive somebody. Anyone? Okay, come on up. Kids love this, by the way. So, and I often do this with the kids I work with. All right, you get to call me anything you want to, and you're not going to be in trouble. Tell this to the kid, I have been called so many good things, so make it good.
I really can't?
You can call me anything. Yes, you can.
You're a motherfucking bastard.
How dare you call me a motherfucking bastard in my own office? I can't believe it. All right, call me again.
You motherfucking bastard.
Call me out my own office. I can't believe it. Yeah, you know what? You're right. I can. All right, one more time.
You motherfucking bastard.
Just try to help. Call the games. Oh, I can't believe it. At which point, the kid's looking at me like, I'm completely nuts. So, what I then say is I ask him the question, basically, who had control of my emotions? You or me? And they're like, me. And I'm like, really? What'd you do each time? This one is like, I was a motherfucking bastard. And I'm like, you called me that 3 times, right? And they're like, yeah. And I'm like, what did I do the first time? And they're like, well, you got mad. And I said, what did I do the second time? And they're like, well, didn't bother you. Kind of laughed. And I'm like, third time, I'm like, got sad. And I'm like, exactly. You didn't make me sad. You didn't make me happy. You didn't make me mad. I got mad. I made that decision, and I could pick any one of those three if I wanted to. Mm-hmm. At which point they're like, wait, no. And then we talk about it a little bit, and they finally start getting, you know what? No, people can't make you have an emotion. Again, they're starting to get a sense of control. Now, the good side of it is then you explain to them, you're no longer responsible for how other people feel. Now, if you've done something, you're going to have to look at it and see how you feel about how you've been affected somebody else. But you're not responsible for how other people feel. But the bad side of it for them is they no longer can claim it's not their fault because somebody made them mad. Well, it wasn't my fault I punched a hole in the wall. They made me mad. So that one doesn't work anymore.